So students, in this lecture we are going to discuss generation of random numbers. As we know that to perform Monte Carlo simulations we need random numbers. So how to generate random numbers is the first question. Now the first method which is used to generate random numbers is basically the mid square generator method. How this mid square generator method works is let me show you. So suppose that you have a seed. Okay, seed is basically some number which you give. Okay, seed is basically an input number. So let you say that you have given 42 initially. Okay, so what this mid square generator method will do, it will square 42. Okay, so let me tell that you have given the first random number which is x0 42. So what they will do is you have to do the square of 42, and the square of 42 will be 1 7 6 4. So what do you do? Remove the first digit and remove the last digit. So what is the number remaining? 76. So your second number, random number, is 76. Now what do you do? That take the square of 76. So it will be 5 7 7 6. Okay, so chop the first and the last digit. So 77 is your next random number. Okay, again what you do, again take the square of 77, and the square of 77 will be 5 9 2 5. Chop the first and last digit, your next random number is 92. Okay, take the square of 92, you will get 8 4 6 4. Okay, and this is your 46. So 46 is your next random number. Okay, then the next method is, next is 46, the square of 46. So it will be 2 1 1 6. So just stop the first and the last digit, you have 11. So your next random number is 11. Okay, take the square of 11. Now it is a three digit number, so it is 121. Now what to do? If you chop the first and last digit, then this method will fail. Okay, so now this method says that you either take these two numbers or these two numbers. So either you can take 12 or 21 as the next random number. Okay, so x6, you can either take 12 or you can take x6 is equal to 21. Okay, now you can see that we have generated a series of number 46 76 77. Okay, 92, 46. Okay, it is 42, sorry, the first number is 42. Okay, so it is 42, 76, 77, 92, 46, 11, okay, 12. So you can see that this all numbers don't have any kind of relation with the previous number. Okay, so a random number is a number which cannot be predicted, but you know that we are using a certain formula. Okay, so if someone knows the seed, okay, that which seed you have used and which method you have used, then they may able to predict this next number. Okay, so we cannot call them a pure random numbers, we call them pseudo random numbers. Okay, Okay, so this are the random numbers. Random numbers are the numbers which cannot be predicted. Okay, so you can see that they are not following any kind of formula or some kind of relation with the previous result or the next result. Okay, so we can call them as a random number. Now you can see that at this point of time it created a problem. Now sometimes it may happen that the middle two numbers are zero. Suppose that you are in a situation where your number is coming 2006, okay, then if you chop the first and the last digit, then you are zero, okay, then the series will never evolve. Okay, so it will become a convergent series, and your generation of random number will stop at that point of time. So this method has a basically some limitations. Okay, what will happen if you take if there is a 5-digit number, okay, 201169, let me say, then if you chop the first and the last digit, then you are having a 3-digit number, let me call this 9, then it is a 3-digit random numbers. So basically sometimes what we want is that the size of the random number should be the same. So if I want two digit random numbers, then I will basically need, want to have a two digit number, and I cannot go to a 3-digit number like a phone number OTP. Generally you see that an OTP which comes to your phone is basically a random number. Okay, so it has some algorithm with which that OTP is generated. Now that random number you always want to be a 6-digit number. Okay, so what will happen if that OTP, this random number generator, is giving you 8-digit number or a 9-digit number? Then the things will become difficult, because there is a general protocol that it will be having a 6-digit, and all the softwares have been designed like this. So there is an issue with this kind of method. Okay, so this is a very traditional method developed by Von Neumann, and it is an old method. The modern method which now the people use is the linear congruent method. Okay, it is very famous and used nowadays. Okay, so what this method says, okay, this method is also known as modulo generator method. So what this method says that next random number xi will be equal to a into xi minus 1 plus c modulo of m, mod of m. Okay, so basically modulo of m basically means that if you are having 5 mod 2, then you have to divide 5 with 2, and what is the remainder? The remainder is 1. So 5 mod 2 is equal to 1. Okay, so this is what modulo operator means. So this is the number. Okay, so a is known as multiplier, c is known as incrementer, and m is the modulo number. So now what you have to do is x minus 1. Okay, so basically if I want to generate the first random number x1, then it is a into x0 plus c mod m. Okay, so here x0 is again the seed. Okay, so you have to give some number from your mind, and that will act as a seed. Okay, and a is your incrementer. So a, c and m are all constants. Okay, and basically you have to define them in such a way that the things become, so that this value of a, c and m will determine the quality of random number generated. So they are very important. So suppose that if I am taking a is equal to 5, okay, c is equal to 1 and m is equal to 8. Okay, so I am taking a is equal to 5, c is equal to 1 and m is equal to 8, and let my seed x0 is equal to 3. Okay, so what will happen? X1 is generally a into x0 plus c mod of m. So here it will be a, which is your 5 into 3 plus 1 mod of 8. So it is 5 threes are 15, 16 mod 8. Okay, so 16 mod 8. So 16, if I divide with 8, then the remainder is 0. So x1 is equal to 0. So your first random number was x0 is equal to 3. And now your x1 is equal to 0. So now I want to find x2. So what will be the value of x2? A into x1 plus c mod of 8. Okay, which is basically a number. So a is your 5 into 0 plus 1 into mod of 8. So it will be 1 mod 8. Okay, so your next, so this will be 1. Okay, now you are having x3, which is a, okay, a is your 5, x2 is your 1 plus 1 mod of 8. So here it is 6 mod 8. So this is 6. Okay, then you can similarly calculate x4. X4 is will be coming out 7. X5 will be coming out to be 4. X6 will be coming out to be 5. X7 will be coming out to be 2. And X8 will be coming out to be 3. Okay, so now what you will see that your seed was 3. Okay, so let me write the entire series. So it was 3, then it came out to be 0, then it was 1, then was 6, then 7, 4, 5, and it was 2. Okay, so you can see that these are 8 numbers. Okay, and after this again 3 came. Okay, and if 3 is coming, then the entire cycle will be repeated again. Okay, so you can see that this is after 8 numbers the cycle is repeating itself because your m is equal to 8. Okay, so m basically defines the period. Okay, okay, so if you know the value of m, you can know that after how many values the random numbers will generate the same series again. Okay, but it is not actually like this, that only this m determines. You can, okay, sometimes the poor choice of a and c can also do this. So suppose that if I am having a is equal to 27, b is equal to 11, and c is equal to 54, then here you can see that c is equal to 11 and m is equal to 54. Okay, so again I have the same problem. Okay, so this is the value of m. So I have a, c and m. So by value of m you can say that the series of random number will be generated after 54 numbers. But you can see that if I take x 0 is equal to 0, then xi is equal to 27. So x1 is equal to 27 into x0, which is your 0 plus 11 mod 54. So if you calculate this value will come out to be 11. Okay. If you calculate the second value, x2, which is 27 into 11 plus 11 mod 54. Okay. Then again, this value will come out to be 38. When you calculate x3, then the value will come out to be 11. Okay. When you will calculate x4, then it will come out to be 38. Okay. So you can see that the cycle will repeat after each second number. Okay. So again, this is not a good random number series. Okay. So there is a problem with this. So a very good choice of A. Okay. A very good choice of A, C and M are very important. Okay. Now, there are some formulas, okay, with some points to remember while you are doing this. The first is that M and C are coprime. Okay, what do we mean by coprime? They don't have any common divisor except one, okay, like 14 and 25. Okay, they don't have any common divisor except one, okay, between them. The second thing to remember is A minus 1 is divisible by all prime factors, okay, of M. The third one is A minus 1 is divisible by 4 if M is divisible by 4. Okay. So if you keep in mind this point, okay, and all these values are very large enough. Okay. So then this thing can work. So this is how, these are the methods by which we can generate random numbers. Okay.